part. I've never seen nothing like that happen in my life. I just keep it. Keeps replaying over and over and over in my head.
Sarah Barrow and her family were spending the day outside when just a street over off Reno and Villa, police began chasing two suspects who were in a stolen vehicle. The pursuit started around 11:15 a.m. and ended around 11:45 in the area of Northwest 22nd and Billen. But what took place between those times will stay with Sarah and her family forever.
We seen the police chase go around and come all the way around.
As the chase moved into the borough's neighborhood, the suspects crashed into a mobile home. Here you can see the tiny space between the shed and the home they crashed into. From there, you can see in the distance, the two in the stolen vehicle narrowly missed crashing into an officer as they came racing down the borough street, clearly with no concern for life. What happened next is too graphic to show. The suspects in the stolen vehicle flew over the railroad tracks at a high speed, hitting and killing the borough's dog. Moments after the accident, Sarah Barrow ran across the street to help her dog, not knowing he only had a short time to live.
About 10 minutes, yeah. He sat there and moaned and groaned, and then he died.
As police pursued the suspect coming over the same tracks, you can see the borough's child trying to cross the street to help his friend. Thankfully, he was held back by Sarah's husband.
I'm glad it was the dog instead of me or my child or, my, you know, any human being.
Which it could have very easily
been. It could have very easy been, yes.
The two in the stolen vehicle crashed into this fence and ran into this residential area, but were apprehended and are now in police custody. Sarah says she just wants justice.
It's really sad, and I just hope that they get punished for what they did.